Okay, so welcome. Today I would like to propose you a session concerning the synthesis of silver nanoprism. So the idea is to work with chemical roots to obtain this nanoprism. And the idea is based on the double reaction of starting silver sources that is reduced and oxidized in the same media. So the idea is to form by a reduction some silver nanosphere or nanoparticles. And in this mixture, because of the presence of an oxidizing agent, you have a dissolution of your particle that go back to the formation of cations. And the idea is that the oxidation is very slow as a comparison to the reduction. So you have a cycling of reaction in your solution. You dissolve, you reform the particles. And because of this very slow kinetic of the oxidation steps, you obtain a fast dissolution of the sphere as a comparison to the prism. So the idea is to form a mixture of particles, dissolve the sphere, and after this dissolution, the prism that stay in solution grows in your solution. So you obtain at the end an increase of the concentration of prism as a comparison of the sphere. And it's possible also to control the size of the prism that you obtain by add some reagents such as bromine that block the growth of some phase of your systems to obtain a control of the size of the prism that you obtain at the end. So to perform this type of reaction, you start with some fresh prepared solution. Of course, you start with sources of silver atoms, so it's silver nitrate. You work with sodium citrate to stabilize your particle in surface because it's a stabilizing agent. And of course, you work with a couple of reducing and oxidizing agents. So for the reducing part, you work with sodium borohydride, that is a fast reducing agent to obtain small particles, and you work with hydrogen peroxide to obtain the oxidation steps. And to control the size of your prism, you add some different concentration of potassium bromide to control the growth of phase using bromine anion that interact with the surface. So all these solutions are prepared here. And now I show you some reaction. So I just transfer my solution. So I have silver nitrate here. So it's just the sources of silver atom. Okay. I have citrate solution to control the stability of the particle in suspension. So, citrate. I have, of course, sodium borohydride to the reduction step. And I have peroxide for the oxidation step. Okay, I can start some experiments. So first, I propose to just synthesize a reference that is a spherical system, so without any presence of the oxidation agent, so without peroxide, just to have a base of synthesis of silver nanoparticles. And after that, I perform some reaction with peroxide in presence of different concentration of bromine. So I work in this type of small system, but you can work in a balloon, of course. So just here. So okay, to obtain a silver nanosphere, I just add a source of silver, of course. So I put 5 milliliters of the silver solution. Okay. I start to mix my solution. Okay. After that, I just add 5 milliliters of water just to have a high volume of solution. So just to obtain a comfortable volume of reaction. So I add 5 milliliters of water. Okay. Now I had just citrate, it's a stabilizing agent, so you didn't have any reaction in this condition with the citrate solution. It's not strong enough to reduce the silver at room temperature, so it's just a stabilizing reagent, so it didn't provoke a reaction in this step. And now I add sodium borohydride to provoke the reduction and provoke the formation of a nuclei that grows in solution to form some nanoparticles. Sorry, 2.5 milliliters. So you see that the coloration change immediately and you obtain the typical coloration of silver nanosphere, this yellow coloration of the solution because of the plasmon absorption bond of silver nanoparticles in this range of size. So with sodium borohydride, you obtain close to 10 nanometer size of the diameter of particles. So you obtain this yellow coloration in solution. So this first experiment is just to have a reference of the spherical systems. And now I would like to perform some reaction to obtain nanoprism by the controlling reaction of reduction oxidation B reaction mode in solution. Okay. So this one, it's okay. So it's the reference spherical systems. So for the nanoprism synthesis, so I propose to perform a large amount of different experiments. As you want, if you have time, you can perform more than the proposal. So the idea is to work with exactly the same condition, but just by the variation of the concentration or the volume of bromine that you put inside your solution to obtain different size of nanoprism. So the protocol is very simple. So you add, of course, first a source of citrate just to obtain a stabilizing media for the silver nanoprism. You add 5 milliliters of silver sources, so the silver nitrate. So of course, it's the same approach than the first reaction. You didn't have any reaction in this case. It's just a mixture of a stabilizing agent and a source of silver. You add the oxidation sources, the peroxide first, because of course, in this condition, you didn't have any reaction also. because of course it's not possible to oxidize more the cation of silver, so you didn't have anything, any reaction in your solution. Now I had small sources of bromine, so in this first experiment I just put 100 microliter of potassium bromine, so it's just small volumes to start, and after that of course in different experiments I increase this concentration. So a small volumes of bromine to manage a little bit the size. So of course all has are ready to react now, and if I had now the sodium borohydride, I provoke the reaction and the reaction starts. So it's the time to start the reaction, and I add a controlling volume of sodium borohydride, and in this case it's I don't have 2.5 milliliters of sodium borohydride. And it starts. So of course, first you see that you obtain the same coloration than the first experiment, because of course you obtain the reduction of silver cations to obtain nanoparticles. And now you wait to obtain the small speed reaction of oxidation that dissolves very slowly your particles to provoke the growth of nanoparticles in solution. So you just wait a little bit, few minutes, to obtain a modification of the coloration in your solution because of the dissolution of your particles and the growth of nanoparticles in this case in solution. I hope that is worked. You see your solution switch in coloration because you dissolve the sphere, and all the cation that is dissolved in solution go to the growth of the prism that stay in solution, because the dissolution of the prism is very slow as a comparison to the sphere. So you obtain at the end the growth of your nanoprism in solution, and this growth is controlled by the concentration of bromine in solution. Okay, so with this first experiment I obtained some nanopin. So now the idea is to perform some reaction by a variation of the concentration of bromine to see if it's possible to change the size, so to see the impact of the concentration of bromine in the formation of your nanopin. So of course if you change the size, you change the absorption properties of your nanomaterials, because of course the absorption plasmon bond depend on the size of your system. So normally you obtain different coloration if you change the size of your system. So in this first experiment I had just 100 microliter of bromine. So the idea is to add more and more concentrated volumes of bromine. So here I test with 200 microliter to see if it's different than for 100 microliter. So I repeat the same procedure, I just change the volume of bromine in my solution. So I start with silver nitrate sources. Okay. Ah no, it's sodium citrate, of course. Sorry, just sodium citrate first. No, I had silver nitrate, not the same volume, 500. After that, 5 milliliters of sodium peroxide, hydrogen peroxide, sorry. And now I change the volume of bromine and I add now 200 microliters in this case. And now, to start the reaction, I had my sodium borohydride to start the reaction. And of course, it's the same procedure. You obtain first a mixture of sphere and quid, so it's the same yellow coloration than the reference samples, because you have a large amount of sphere in this case. And after a few minutes, normally, the coloration switch to because of the formation of nanoclines that grow in solution. So of course here, if you increase the concentration of bromine, you block more the phase of growth. So normally you obtain smaller particles, and it's what I would like to show you after that in the UV visible spectroscopy, to see if the plasmonic bands shift, blue shift to a small value because of the small size of the particle system. So you observe the same switch of coloration, and normally the distribution of size is a little bit different than the first experiment. So okay, so now the third experiment, so it's the same, but I increase much more the concentration of bromide. So in the last experiment, I had 200 microliters of bromide. So now I would like to add 250 microliters of bromide. And all the same reagent in the same concentration. So I didn't change the volume or the concentration of other reagent. So I had first 2 milliliters of citrate. Now 5 milliliters of silver nitrate, the source of silver. 5 milliliters. Five milliliters also of hydrogen peroxide. And now, of course, I changed the volume of bromine. I put 250 now to increase this concentration. And finally, to start the reaction, I put 2050 microliters, to 2 milliliters and a half milliliter of sodium borohydride. the section start to shift in coloration. And of course, I don't know if it's possible to see here, but the coloration, it's shift as a function of the condition. So, okay, so you can prepare a large amount of different experiments. So you see that here I progress in my concentration effect of the bromide. So I start with just 100 microliters here. I put 200 microliters here, 250, 300, 350 microliters of bromine. So you obtain different type of coloration as a function of the concentration of bromine put in solution. And now I start for the last one. But of course, you can, as you want, perform some tests with other intermediate volume to obtain a large amount of samples, of course. So the last one, it's with 400 microliters of bromine in this case. So I repeat exactly the same process, of course. So I start with citrate, 2 milliliters of citrate. Okay. 5 milliliters of silver nitrate. Okay. 5 milliliters of hydrogen peroxide. Okay. 400 microliters of bromine. And to start the reaction, 250 microliters of sodium borohydride. So, of course, if you add a large amount of bromine, of course, you block the surface of some phase of growth. So, of course, you play a role also on the kinetic of the formation of your nanoprism. And in higher concentration of bromine, of course, you obtain smaller particles. And because you have more time to obtain a large amount of particles that grow with a smaller size. And of course, the kinetics of growth is very slow as a comparison of a very low concentration of bromine. So of course, you play on the kinetic of growth by the concentration of bromine that you put in solution. So it's why you see that the color change of your solution, it's slower than the first experiment. And okay, it's finished for this step. For all your preparation are done. So now you want to analyze all your particles by UV visible spectroscopy to observe the formation of prism and the control of size that you obtain with this type of reaction. Okay, so at the end of your practical session, you can measure all your samples by UV visible spectroscopy to observe the effect of the size that you obtain as a function of the concentration of bromine. So I have here just an absorption spectrophotometer, so I would like to measure absorption. And in this condition of work, the absorption is not too high to measure, to dilute your system. So you can measure directly your suspension without any dilution. So it's very comfortable. So of course, by UV visible spectroscopy, you measure the absorption of light of sources, and you want to measure a Planck force first, so the background, to didn't have any problem of the cuve diffusion or something like that. So of course, in this case, you work in water, so you just measure the absorption of your cells with just water to obtain the background. And of course, the absorption wavelength of this type of nanopins, it's around all the visible, so you measure between 200 nanometers to 800 nanometers to obtain all the spectrum of the pins that you obtain. So I manage that here. So I just measure between 200 nanometers to 800 nanometers. Okay. And I just start to measure the background. So I start. He asked me to add the background. So I put the background in the apparatus. And I just measure the background first. So of course I propose to measure just to synthesize just a spherical sample, so the first one, the first experiment, just to have a reference of the absorption of spherical systems, and after that it's easy to compare the absorption peak that you obtain for prism as a function of sphere and for different size of prism after. So okay, I start with the first sample, so it's just a spherical system, so spherical nanoparticles, silver nanoparticles of course. So I just add some small volume of solution in my tube. And I put that in my apparatus, it's okay. And I start the measurement of the absorption spectrum. So, okay, you measure with a large amount of wavelength, but you see that you obtain a large amount here, corresponding to a silver nanosphere, and the size of particle it's small because you obtain a maximum of wavelength that is below 400 nanometers, so it's corresponding to a silver nanoparticle with around 10 nanometer size or something like that. Okay, so it's typical, the typical spectrum of nanosphere with some distribution of size, of course, but you obtain one typical absorption band here in the system. So now you want to measure all your samples, nanopin samples. So I start with the small concentration of bromine, so it's just 100 microliter of bromine. So normally you obtain very large nanoparticles, nanoprism, of course. So you can see that the rotation is completely different than for the sphere. And you see that you absorb in a large game of wavelength in this case, because of course you didn't had a large amount of bromine, so you didn't control very well the growth, so you have a mixture of different sizes at the end, and the size is very large. But you can see, but maybe it's more easy to see, observe that after, but if you look the spectrum, so it's a green curve here, you see that you have a first maximum here, a first small band here, at 240 nanometers here. You have another maximum here, around 400 nanometers, and after that, a band here. So the first small peak here, it's corresponding to the oscillation of electrons at the extremity of the nanoprism. It's due because of it's a crystal growth, so you didn't have a nice finition of the prism at the end. It's shrunk by just the faces of your crystals. So you have a small oscillation in this direction, corresponding to a very small wavelength here. The second peak at around 400 nanometers, so it's close to the sphere, it's corresponding to the depth of your nanoprism. So of course you have three-dimensional properties, and you have oscillation in the depth of your prism, and it's close to the absorption of a small sphere, of course. And after that, the position of the large band here depend on the size of your prism. More the prism is large, more the absorption is redshift, of course. So you have three different bands in this case. So okay, now it's the results after the measurement of all the samples. So would like to explain some observations. So of course it's not easy to compare the value of absorbance. It's because we measure just after the synthesis your samples, and you have a lot of bubbles due to the degradation of sodium borohydride. So of course if you wait 21 day, it's more easy after that to compare this value. But if you measure just after the synthesis, you have some problem of diffusion of bubbles, so it's not easy to compare. But it's interesting to compare in this case the form, the value of absorbance, the wavelength of absorbance. And so I start here with the spherical system. So I express that it's small particle because you have an absorption below 400 nanometers. So this first experiment with a low concentration of bromine, you obtain nanoprism, but you see that the band is not very well formed, it's very large. So it's because you didn't put enough bromine to control very well the growth. So of course you obtain a mixture of size, and you didn't control very well your systems. But now, if you increase the concentration of bromine, you obtain first this spectrum. So you see this first peak corresponding to the oscillation in the extremity of your prism, and you obtain a more definite band here. And after that, you see that as a function of the concentration of bromine, you shift slowly, but after that more rapidly the band here. And you see that in a certain range of concentration, you obtain a very nice control of size. You see this band, and this band as an example. And it's a concentration, a range of concentration of bromine that it's very, that's work very well for the control of size. So of course, if you put a small amount of bromine, you didn't control very well the size. If you put more, a large amount of bromine, you saturated the system, so you obtain very small particles. But in a certain range of concentration, it's possible to control very well the size of prism that you obtain. And you can have some different experiments with very small different concentration of bromine to obtain all the size that absorb in all the range of the visible part of the light. So you obtain here a very nice control of size if you work in the last experiment and the with a small amount of concentration and something like that, and you shift the size as a function of the concentration of bromine here.